The first white men of your people who came to our country were named Lewis and Clark. All Nez Perce made friends with Lewis and Clark and agreed to let them pass through their country and never to make war on white men. This promise the Nez Perce have never broken. It has always been the pride of the Nez Perce that they were the friends of the white men. Chief Joseph.
In 1871, an aging Nez Perce chief summoned one of his sons, Himatuyalatkek, also called Joseph, to his deathbed. Their homeland in the Wallawa country of northeastern Oregon was being overwhelmed by white settlers. After three quarters of a century of unbroken peace with the United States, the Nez Perce felt betrayed. Although the government claimed a treaty permitted the new settlements, Joseph's band had never signed that treaty and insisted the land still belonged to them.
My father was the first to see through the schemes of the white men. He said, "My son, when I am gone, you are the chief of these people. Always remember that your father never sold his country. You must stop your ears whenever you are asked to sign a treaty selling your home. My son, never forget my dying words. This country holds your father's body. Never sell the bones of your father and mother." I pressed my father's hand and told him I would protect his grave with my life. A man who would not love his father's grave is worse than a wild animal. Chief Joseph.